Hi, I'm Jordan Rubin. Welcome to Ancient Medicine Today. Do you have leg cramps? Is your energy less than what it should be? Do you have soft bones? Maybe your doctors told you you have osteopenia? Or what about just a general malaise mid-afternoon? You know what? You could be magnesium deficient. Not caffeine deficient, not stimulant deficient, magnesium deficient. And on today's episode of Ancient Medicine Today, brought to you by DrAxe.com, we're gonna share with you how you can determine if you're magnesium deficient, and best of all, how to fix it. Magnesium is a mineral, may not be as popular as calcium, may not be as popular as iron, but I gotta tell you, if you wanna relax, if you want to perform better, if you wanna have more energy and a healthier heart, you need to make sure that you have the appropriate amount of magnesium in your diet and therefore in your body. Let's get started. Here are some of the symptoms that will tell you if you're magnesium deficient. Check this out. Leg cramps we talked about. Insomnia. There are tens of millions of people that have sleep issues. Muscle pain. If you have muscle pain, just random muscle pain, kind of like leg cramps, you could be magnesium deficient. What about anxiety? Magnesium can help you chill out. High blood pressure, how many people deal with that? What if it isn't a deficiency in medication, but it's really a deficiency in magnesium? Type 2 diabetes. Many people who have fluctuating blood sugar levels have a need for more magnesium. Fatigue, we mentioned that. General malaise, you don't have that get up and go. Could be magnesium deficiency. Here's a big one, migraines. Really any type of headaches that happen in clusters could be a symptom of magnesium deficiency. And last but not least, osteoporosis or even osteopenia. Magnesium is critical to build bone mass. Who is most at risk of magnesium deficiency? If you've got gut issues, absorption issues, Crohn's disease, ulcerative colitis, IBS, chronic diarrhea, constipation, gluten intolerance, all of these gut issues can cause a magnesium deficiency. What about heartburn, acid reflux? And if you're taking those medications to lower acid, that could compromise your ability to utilize calcium and magnesium. Type 2 diabetics. Once again, if you have been diagnosed with type 2 diabetes or if you have obesity, you are at risk of being magnesium deficient. The elderly. Elderly individuals often have compromised magnesium levels, intake, and absorption. And alcoholics. If you drink a lot of alcohol and have liver issues, which is almost always the case, you could have a challenge metabolizing magnesium. Folks, I'm Jordan Rubin here for Ancient Medicine Today, brought to you by DrAxe.com. And if you're someone who wants to build a healthy body and a healthy life, you need to know if you're magnesium deficient and, best of all, how to remedy the situation. See, we teach you every day that food is medicine. And if you know somebody who has GI issues, type 2 diabetes, everyone knows someone who's elderly, or someone who has issues with consuming alcohol, therefore liver challenges, why don't you go ahead and punch that share button? Send this link to them, because so many people, and I'm talking about from children to the elderly, are dealing with magnesium issues, and it's affecting your heart. It's affecting your immune system. It's affecting your muscular skeletal system. It's affecting your brain and sleep and eyes, etc. Magnesium is so, so important, and it doesn't get enough credit. Now, here's the benefits of getting enough magnesium. We're going to talk about diet. We're going to talk about supplements. But look at this. Magnesium optimal quantities will give you increased energy, calms the nerves. It chills you out. Improve sleep. Here's a big one. You can ease constipation with magnesium. Again, we're going to talk about ways to get it in your diet. I'll even share with you a little story. Relieves muscle aches. This is big if you're active or even if you're not as active as you'd like to be. Magnesium regulates the absorption and utilization of other nutrients. Calcium, potassium, other electrolytes, macro and trace minerals, and certain vitamins. Supports your heart. Magnesium is a great big boost for your heart. And you can prevent migraines and headaches. and boost your bone health. So folks, here's how you get more magnesium in your life. These are all magnesium-rich foods. Think fruits, vegetables, and whole animal foods. They all have magnesium, particularly if you consume animal foods where there's edible bones. We'll talk about that in a moment. So spinach and char, greens are great sources of magnesium. Seeds are amazing, including pumpkin seeds. Yogurt or kefir, use the whole milk variety. I like sheep or goat, or an African-inspired dairy beverage known as amasi, really, really good. Almonds are a great source of magnesium. Black beans, avocados, figs. Figs are so great. Dr. Josh and I talk about how beneficial figs are. They don't get enough respect either. They're a good source of magnesium as well as fiber and enzymes. Dark chocolate, yes. Dark chocolate is great for your brain and it helps you get in a better mood. Not just because of the theanine and the caffeine that it has, not just because of the antioxidants, but because of the magnesium. Get the darkest you can, over 70%, and try organic chocolate to make sure you're getting the cleanest source. Bananas are also a great source of magnesium. Green vegetables, seeds, and fruits, vegetables, and some legumes are great sources of magnesium. When you want to supplement with magnesium, here are some sources. I like enzyme-activated magnesium. It's also known as multi-amino acid chelated magnesium. That's my favorite. It's a really cool process that takes magnesium and makes it more friendly to the body. You can do a single magnesium amino acid chelate. Magnesium citrate is a good source of magnesium to get in the system, but also help regulate your bowels. You can use magnesium glycinate, threonate, and probably my second favorite source, magnesium oil. Now, magnesium oil is not actually an oil. In fact, it's a sea mineral blend that feels like oil. So if you've got an ache or a pain, or you just want to absorb some magnesium to sleep better or boost your mood, spray some magnesium oil on your abdomen, about 20 sprays, or the area that hurts. If you want more information about magnesium oil, visit draxe.com and check it out. This is really, really cool. Also for your kids, if they can't sleep or if they're, let's just say, high strung, spray a little magnesium oil right on their neck. Rub it there. If you've got a headache, you can rub it here. Magnesium oil is a great medium for essential oils as well. Bottom line with magnesium, get more of it if you're experiencing any of the symptoms we mentioned earlier or if you are one of the at-risk populations. Okay, so when you're taking magnesium, how do you optimize it? Well, these are supporting nutrients and beneficial compounds, probiotics. A good gut helps you utilize foods better and process minerals. Calcium, we need a good source of calcium. Believe it or not, some of the best sources of calcium come from animal foods. We also know they come from plant foods too. I like acidified sources of calcium. Pictured there would be whole milk yogurt and curd cheese. Raw cheeses are great. Cultured dairy is great. Greens are great as well, but make sure to get calcium in your diet. A lot of the magnesium-rich foods such as almonds are a good source. Believe it or not, even carrot juice is a good source. You need to get dietary calcium, and if you want to supplement, I like calcium from algae, and there's also some cool calcium supplements that are made from animal sources that also have phosphorus, which helps to build bones. Vitamin D is a big one. You'll find this in calcium supplements, calcium, vitamin D, magnesium, and vitamin K2. Vitamin D from the sun, or from supplements, or from foods like sardines, wild salmon, cod liver oil is another great source. We need to optimize vitamin D. A lot of deficiency in America, but just as much deficiency as magnesium. Bone broth. Bone broth is loaded with sodium and potassium and other compounds that act similar to magnesium. The proteins in bone broth, including proline and glycine, help to calm the body and build the structural system. In fact, your bones have more protein than they do calcium. And what kind of protein? The same protein as in bone broth. This is an extract of the best part of your bones. Chicken bones, that is, or beef or fish. These are four powerful supporting foods, nutrients, or compounds to round out your health program for your heart, for your brain, your sleep, headaches, etc. Really, really good. Consume all of these. Supplement, sunshine, food, and food or supplements. Get them any way you can. They're amazing. Okay, here's ways to block calcium magnesium absorption. So if you have issues with magnesium, it might not be that you're not getting enough, but you're not absorbing it. So here are absorption blockers. Foods with phytates, that would be soy foods, legumes that are not soaked or sprouted, grains have phytates, gluten is similar to a phytate, all of those can block magnesium absorption. So we saw that chocolate is a source of magnesium, as is black beans, but it's a little more difficult to absorb that magnesium than, say, juicing greens. So you want to lower the phytic acid in your diet because that competes and or blocks mineral absorption. High oxalate foods. Oxalates are found in spinach. They're found in certain legumes, and they can bind with magnesium. Go online. Actually, you can go to draxe.com and look up high oxalate foods, and you'll learn which foods to lower. Some medications block your ability to utilize magnesium. The problem is, even though medications help with a symptom, they often disturb enzyme systems that alter absorption of key vitamins and minerals. So when you're on a medicine, it will typically deplete certain vitamins and minerals in the body or beneficial compounds, and it's critical to know about it. If you're interested in more information on that, search drug nutrient depletions and find out what you may need to be supplementing with. Alcohol compromises the liver, which will compromise your magnesium absorption. Crash dieting, if you're someone who yo-yo diets, you go on all kinds of high fat, low fat, all meat, all veggie. You fast, you eat. If you do that, oftentimes you will be dehydrated and mineral deficient. Estrogen dominance, if you're someone who has a lot of materials in your home that are toxic, you use a lot of plastics, you use a lot of aluminum, you have been on lots of medications and you know that these xenoestrogens or xenobiotics are in your body. You lack progesterone. That is a condition that allows for low magnesium, and in fact it might be very chicken and egg. Maybe the magnesium deficiency produces estrogen dominance. High cortisol levels. If you're someone who's an adrenaline junkie, if you are tired in the morning and wired at night, if you have a little weight around the midsection, if you're not in a good mood and you are aging quicker than you should, probably have high cortisol. One of the best ways to lower cortisol is through adaptogenic herbs. Think ashwagandha, rhodiola, eleuthero, Schizandra, those are great, and adaptative exercise. Think yoga, Pilates, gyrotonic, barre, walking barefoot outside in the grass or on the ocean, or by the ocean. Walking on the ocean would be really cool, but walking by the ocean, that can all help lower your cortisol levels and bring your adrenal glands back to proper health. And a high sugar diet compromises everything, but definitely makes for magnesium deficiency. In fact, a high sugar diet causes multiple mineral deficiencies because you're eating something in sugar that was never meant to be consumed in such high amounts. The insulin levels, the blood sugar issues, all will inhibit your proper mineralization of your body. Folks, think about this. The Bible says we were made from the dust of the earth. We eat plant foods, we eat animal foods, but there are no vitamins in the soil, only minerals. Minerals are critical to start the entire process. They're catalysts, if you will. Mineral deficiency shows up in so many ways, as we talked about on this episode, and I bet 75% of you watching are magnesium deficient. And I want to make sure that if you're a regular viewer of Ancient Medicine Today, that you pay particular attention to share this video, because I believe that almost everyone you know could benefit from avoiding some of these magnesium absorption blockers, from adding some of the supporting nutrients, some of the supplements, and ways to get magnesium in. We didn't even mention taking an Epsom salt bath, which is using magnesium sulfate. You can buy it at your local grocery or drugstore. That's great. So we want to make sure that America has a healthy heart, healthy brain, healthy mood, gets good sleep, and builds strong bones, and magnesium will help you do it. Here's a recap. Magnesium-rich foods, spinach and chard, lots of greens are really good. Seeds such as pumpkin seeds, nuts like almonds, yogurt and kefir, use whole milk. Black beans, soak them first or buy pre-soaked. Avocados, I love avocados, good for so many things. Figs, dark chocolate, 70% or more, and bananas. Who is at risk of magnesium deficiency? Gut issues. If you've got gut issues, leaky gut, Crohn's, ulcerative colitis, IBS, constipation, diarrhea, or any level of gluten sensitivity or celiac, you probably have magnesium deficiency. Type 2 diabetes or type 1. Anyone with diabetes is at risk of being mineral deficient. Magnesium really helps. Elderly typically lose more bone mass than they gain. You need more minerals. Anyone who's abused alcohol with liver issues needs more magnesium. Supporting nutrients and beneficial compounds, probiotics in supplement and food form, calcium in supplement and food form, vitamin D in sunshine, food and supplement form, and bone broth in any form you can get it in are all great to support magnesium absorption and the overall benefits that magnesiums can bring. Here's the best way to get magnesium: enzyme activated, magnesium chelate, magnesium citrate, these are all readily available, glycinate, threonate, and one of my favorites, magnesium oil. For more information on the benefits of magnesium and how to get more, visit draxe.com. You'll find a great article on the subject with expanded information. I'm Jordan Rubin. God bless, and see you next time.